Oh, not terrible.
At that exact moment, she then realized she was fucked.
Not terrible, but damn. So right now I'm hoping that it's stuck on and it shouldn't be. That would be your best case scenario. So there's a part in here that does that. Yeah. You know what? We're gonna kill power to it first. Which is blazing hot, by the way. All right, and that turns off, but wow. So remember how that one, I showed you the one over there melting, right? So the wiring going to the, what we call the contactor or the high voltage and low voltage switch is melted.
Oh, so that's why it's stuck on?
Well, this part, you can come over here, it's not gonna bite you if you want to. But this part right here gets a signal from the thermostat to turn on, and then it takes high voltage, which is here, and it turns on. Yeah, everything's off. It's not gonna bite you, but it takes high voltage here, and it sends it to the compressor, and then the fan. But this thing right here, which normally opens and closes. Yeah. So if you were to turn that thermostat on right now, this will open and close. Should it was stuck in the closed position, energizing everything, and that's why if you notice how the wiring here. Is
a little burnt,
frayed, and the incoming voltage as well. And there's a reason why that's hot as can be.
Okay.
3 hours later.
Can you move it along? I'm all out of time cards.
All right. It's been about 26 hours since we uncovered this unit, really frozen solid. I just turned on the switch on top of the air handler that gave us 24 volts and that gave us blower motor operation. My thermostat has a call for cooling, and we're gonna take off the front cover here and see what's going on. Now yesterday we did manually pull that contactor open. Right now she's energized. Let me grab my Vito, and what I'm gonna do right now is carefully pull one of our 24 volts going to the contactor. See, and she did open. So, but if you're taking a look at the condition of our contactor, the wires that have melted, we're gonna swap that out. This is a single pole contactor. Let me just put this like right there. This is a single pole contactor. There's a shunt there. So L1, L2, T1, T2, 24 volt coil. And looking very sus. Very, very sus. And overall condition of this system is poor. I would say fair to poor, but everything is thought out. I swap out this contactor. I got a new Packard right here. Contactor flip, nailed it. Shout out to that YouTuber, Instagrammer, who's an HVAC contractor in Palm Beach County. Buddy, I'll be seeing you soon. So you could put in a two-pole contactor if you don't have a crankcase heater. We don't have one, but we're just gonna duplicate what we have there now. Put this in its place and have a nice day. I got my voltmeter out. Let's just check for voltage. Make sure we are safe to work on this. There's nothing there. Nothing there either. Perfect. That is that 24 volt, which is actively calling. Let's be careful here and let's carefully pull this wire out without shorting it out. Okay, let me grab my contactor. And let's be careful there, buddy. You gotta be careful there. We do not want to touch metal with this wire. So let's get one right there. Beautiful. Okay, let's just get this out of the way for right now. Let's put this right there. Beautiful. Now, this yellow wire is the other side of that contactor. Now, here is our 24 volts coming, or signal coming from our thermostat and our air handler when there's a R and Y are energized. So this Y here is going to, looks like we have a high pressure switch, low pressure switch, and that's gonna break condenser operation if one of those two conditions are present. So if you ever have like a system that turns on for a few seconds and turns off and then waits for a few seconds and does it over and over and over again, chances are you have a low pressure switch issue, low pressure, maybe a frozen system, low refrigerant, restriction of refrigerant, things like that. But if you have a high pressure issue, chances are the condenser fan motor is not operating, or our condensing coil is clogged. You're not discharging that heat fast enough, that pressure, and that's going to trip the high pressure switch. And that's a manual reset one right there. See that little button? See? So what's kind of interesting is yesterday when the system was frozen solid, it was not out on low pressure. Interesting. I'm going to show you guys something real quick. Watch this. See that? Coil's energized because it's getting 24 volts. All right, let me get my flat screwdriver and take these conductors from T1, T2, L1, L2, and then pull out my contactor. Sometimes you even have to cut the conductors out of the equation. Wow. Pretty intense. Let me get that. I loosened that up off camera. Now let's get our 5/16. Let's take out the screws that are holding down the contactor. And then we're gonna have an orange and two blacks. Two blacks and an orange, remember that. All right, the new contactor is in. It does not make a difference what side you're using as long as you keep all the wires together. Especially if you have, like you're going to the contactor, you're gonna make sure you put the capacitor, make sure your common is going where it should. If you reverse that, you're gonna have problems with system operational. So there's that, contactor is in. Here's the old one. Let's check the coil resistance. I'm gonna put that on ohms. Let's get a couple alligator clips and let's see what our resistance is on this coil. So let's put one right there. Let's get the other lead. Let's put that on there. Forgive me, I'm doing this one-handedly. You guys know how it is. Let's get that in right there. Perfect. And right there. So believe it or not, the coil is fine. Just had stuck contactor points. And that was keeping a compressor and condenser fan motor running even when there wasn't a call for cooling. And if you didn't have fan motor operation, you have a restriction of airflow, system's gonna freeze up. So that's that. Now, before I plug in power, let's set this to read amperage. Let's put one. What am I even doing it there? Let me go down here where we have all this mess going on right here. That looks like it's ground. Okay, let's put that there. I'm gonna set that to read min-max. I wanna see what my LRAs are. Max. And 121. It's running. Yeah. Yeah, 141, so you're still under specification for that. All right, folks, another satisfied residential client. If you live in the Long Island, New York City metropolitan area and you're tired of getting bamboozled by your HVAC contractor, I want you to pick up the phone and give me a call, 516-348-6300, or save time, book online at pipedoc.net. Me and my team would love to help you. Thank you so much for watching. Catch you in the next one. Be well, God bless, stay safe.